Okay, we're on the chapter on performance, breach, and remedies. Obviously, the most common way for a contract to be discharged or ended is by full performance by both sides. I agree to sell you my used tennis racket. You agree to pay me $10, and that is complete performance. That terminates the contract. Now, obviously, we can have substantial performance. Let's say that I contract with you to mow and sweep my lawn, and I agree to pay you $30, and you finish up and you come to get your $30, and then you say, you know, I think I didn't sweep up a blade of grass around the side of the house. Well, that's not complete performance. And I could say, you know, I could get the neighbor kid to pick up that piece of grass for $1, so I'll pay you $29. That would be substantial performance. You could have a contract that is written to your satisfaction. Let's say you want your portrait painted by a famous artist, and he's going to charge you $30,000 to do that. And the contract clearly says that the contract is to your satisfaction. You must be satisfied. Even if everybody else in the world thinks it's a terrific painting, if you, in all sincerity and truth, say, I don't like it, then you don't have to pay for it. That rule applies if the object of the contract is artistic, like a painting or a sculpture or even plastic surgery. However, if it's for a non-artistic result, as in putting a sidewalk in front of a house, laying the concrete, if it's non-artistic and you say it's to my satisfaction, the courts have always ruled that to mean it's really to the satisfaction of a reasonable third party. Okay, let's go over here and let's talk about material breach. Let's say that you order a Lamborghini automobile and the dealership brings it out to your house and unloads the car from the car carrying truck. And the car turns out to be a 1999 Ford Aspire with 186,000 miles on it. Well, that's a complete material breach of contract, and the contract is at an end. All right, let's talk about ending a contract by agreement of the parties. Obviously, both parties could just sign a contract saying the first contract is no longer in effect. There are other ways that the parties can agree to terminate a contract. You can look at these in your book. One is called novation. Another is called discharge by substituted agreement. And another is called accord, like the Honda, ACCORD, and satisfaction. We can have discharge by operation of law, and there are a handful of ways to do that. Discharge means ending a contract. You could have discharge by operation of law due to impossibility. Let's say you and I sign a contract that you will pay me $5,000 and I promise to throw a baseball to the planet Jupiter. Well, that's not possible, so that contract is discharged. If you agree to come and sing at my daughter's wedding and you die the week before, well, that contract is discharged. If I agree to sell you my used Volkswagen and I'm going to deliver it on Friday, and Thursday there's a fire at my house and the Volkswagen's in the garage and it gets destroyed in the fire, that's discharged by destruction of the object. You could have discharge by commercial impracticability, which means that it is Very, very, very unexpectedly more expensive to perform the contract than anyone could have ever expected. That would discharge the contract. You could have discharge by subsequent illegality. That means that after we agree to contract, what we agree to contract for becomes illegal. If you agree to build a house for me in San Diego, and you're going to start construction the first of next year, and next month the San Diego City Council says no more residential construction in San Diego, then subsequent to the contract, it became illegal to do subsequent illegality. Finally, frustration of purpose. That's a fun way to discharge a contract. You want to read about that in the book. And there is a fun video on King Edward on this. That's it. Bye.